Today's coffee break is on using subcontractors during the manufacturing process. So this is a follow-up to our previous coffee break, which was setting up subcontractors for the manufacturing process. So once you've got them all set up, you come here and you're in the right place, and we'll go ahead and use all those setups that we created in the previous video. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a release production order. The components will be sent to our subcontractor to fulfill a requirement. To do the release production order, I just go to execution, and I'm going to click on release production orders, and we're going to create a new one here. This is going to be our finished item, and let's go ahead and order 25 of these. Now when I do the refresh, click OK, you'll see that the parent item comes in. And what I want to do here is I want to put in our location. So our warehouse is the blue warehouse. So the parent item exists only in the blue warehouse. On the components, however, we want to go ahead and put in the vendor's location, our subcontractor's location. This way we can eventually ship the components to the subcontractor so they can work their magic, and then they can give us back the finished good. So that's where we do that. So let's go ahead and close this. Now that we've done that and we've created our release production order for that finished good with the components going to the vendor location, we can go ahead and create a transfer order to move those components to the vendor location. And the way we do that is we go ahead and we go to our planning. We want to go to our planning worksheet. We're just going to calculate. Okay, so now it's coming up with those two component items, and it's telling us to create a new transfer order. So we want to go ahead and do that, and I'm going to go ahead and click on Carry Out Action Message. And I just want to make sure that on the transfer orders selection, there's a drop down here, and I want to go ahead and I'm just going to make a transfer order, but you can print them out as well. So I click OK. The lines disappear. And now when I go to my transfer orders, I see here that it's put those two components on and the correct quantities, and it's saying that we're going to transfer them from our blue location to our vendor's location. So now all your normal transfer processes that happen in your warehouse would occur. I'm going to go ahead and post this, and I'm going to say, okay, we shipped them out, and I'm going to go ahead and post the receipt as well. So I'm pretending now that the vendor has received those components. Once that step's done, we need to do the next part, which is creating the PO that goes to the vendor or the subcontractor. So we go back to planning, and we have here subcontracting worksheets, and we want to just go ahead and calculate the subcontractor. And it comes in, and here's my parent item. And right here I have a vendor already set up. Now, when we did our setups, we defaulted certain things to this vendor. You don't have to. You can leave the vendor blank. Or you can put a vendor in, and at this point you could actually send it off to a different vendor. So if you have multiple subcontractors and you're not really sure who you're going to use until the last minute, you certainly can change the vendor at this point. We're going to go ahead and keep this, and we're just going to carry out action message. Okay, and let's go take a look at that purchase order that was created, because it's a little bit different. A normal purchase order is not connected to a production order, but these are. So you'll see here the parent item, the final quantity, which is 25, and then down here I have all my production order information. The reason that's important is eventually we're going to receive this item, and when we do, it will actually go to that production order and mark the quantity as finished. That's how it knows which production order to mark as finished. Let's go ahead and close this. And the next thing I want to do is calculate the consumption. So I'm going to go to my consumption journal. Calculate consumption. And we'll just choose that one production order that we're working on. I believe that's it. Here we go. So now I have my components and I have their quantities, and I see them coming out of that vendor location over here. So at this point, we're just click post. And now we've calculated our consumption, we've posted our consumption. And normally at this point, you would receive the PO. So the vendor sends you the finished good. So we're going to go back to the planning. We're going to open up that PO again. All right, and we're going to go ahead and say that we received that finished product. So the finished product's coming back into our blue location. I'm just going to post it. And let's go see what it did to our production order. So if I go back here to my execution, and I look at my release production orders, here it is down here. You see here the quantity that's finished is 25. So this is ready now to be marked as finished, but before I do that, I just want to show you something real quick. On the Navigate, we have our entries, and we have our item ledger entries. And here you can see the consumption of the components and the output, and you see that they're coming out of that vendor location, and the output's coming into our blue location. And that's it. That's how you set up the subcontractor so that you can use it for your transfer orders and your purchase orders and tie it all together with your manufacturing process.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.